Nine wants to know has learned former Sheriff Patrick Sullivan is in trouble with his probation officer. 3 months after pleading guilty in his meth-for-sex case, Sullivan has received sanctions for probation violations. Jeremy Hohola has exclusive information on what could be behind all this. Jeremy, what'd you find?
Well, today, Kyle, according to court documents that we obtained, Patrick Sullivan's probation officer has notified the court this past month in July of, quote, continued violations. Now, these court documents are vague, but a report by his probation officer says Sullivan has been, quote, soliciting, unquote, someone that he used to pay in the past. What Sullivan paid for in the past is not clear. It's not spelled out in the court documents, but it is clear that his current probation officer has a concern with the relationship that Sullivan is having. Here's part of what that probation officer's report says. In this transaction, the defendant, Sullivan, selected his partner to be someone whom he previously had authority over. The document goes on to say that it indicates issues related to power and control. Nine News legal analyst Scott Robinson believes the probation officer is concerned that Sullivan is having an intimate relationship with someone that may be inappropriate. As a result of these apparent probation violations, it's been noted in this probation officer's report that Sullivan is now part of the SCRAM program. That's a program that outfits people on probation with an ankle monitor that can detect blood alcohol and their location through GPS. We just found out this information this afternoon, so we are still waiting to hear from Sullivan's attorneys and the probation department if they'll call back and even comment. The probation report was submitted this past July, so still no word if there are continued probation violations this month, but we can tell you that other court documents in this case filed just this week are sealed. So who knows what else is in that court record, Kyle.
All right, Jeremy, thank you.